Amir Benno is back with us on short notice. Amir, we appreciate you being with us this morning. Mike Pence, the vice president, says he is not going to invoke the 25th Amendment. There is no reason to invoke the 25th Amendment. As I understand it, the amendment was established if a president loses his mental capacity or is shot, or if something happens and affects his direct ability to govern. That is clearly not the case with President Trump. What are your thoughts?
Well, you're 100% right. It was developed, first of all, came into to the thought process was when Nixon was vice president to Eisenhower, and Eisenhower had several health issues, and they had sort of a gentleman's agreement as to how the transfer of power would proceed if something happened to Eisenhower, who was at the time the oldest president ever to be elected. He was 70 years old. After that administration, of course, came Kennedy, who was the youngest president, and that sort of went by the wayside until Kennedy was assassinated. In the wake of that, the 25th Amendment was passed in 1967. And you're correct. The only times that it's ever been invoked is when presidents have been under anesthesia for medical procedures.
Right.
It was done when Ronald Reagan had a procedure, and it was done again when George W. Bush was. It has never been weaponized as Pelosi and Chuck Schumer have suggested now, to use it for political objectives. And it's a very scary tactic, because the way that the 25th Amendment works is the vice president, if he has a majority of the cabinet, there's 14 cabinet secretaries plus the attorney general, so he would only need 8 people to join with Vice President Pence in transmitting a letter to the Congress saying that the president is unable to discharge his duties. After that, the president would respond, presumably saying that he is, with his full faculties, and able to do his job. And if the president does that, then the vice president, again, with a majority of the cabinet, can contest that statement. If the vice president contests it, the Congress has 21 days to make a decision. They have to vote on it and they have to determine that he's unable to discharge his duties by 2/3 of the each house of Congress. But during that 21 days, and this is where it gets scary, during that 21 days, President Trump, would be stripped of his powers, and Vice President Pence would be acting president. So you don't need a vote. You just would need the vice president with a majority of his cabinet. And as we saw with the resignations of Betsy DeVos and Elaine Chao yesterday, it seems to be that there is some division, obviously, within his cabinet.
Well,
and so to use this amendment for political objectives is really tremendously frightening.
Yeah, and I don't want to lead you here. Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer in particular, they claim the moral high ground. They did this summer while there were protests throughout the country. How can you claim the moral high ground and try to impeach a president for the second time? Listen, Wednesday was a tragic day. It'll go down in history as a tragic day. We just found out today that a member of the Capitol Hill Police, Brian Sicknick, has died due to injuries that he sustained in the protests, the riots that happened on Capitol Hill on Wednesday. But I thought this was interesting. The Wall Street Journal editorial board published an article saying that President Trump should resign, and that would be best for the country. That surprised me, given he's got 12 days left in office. He is acknowledging that now. Here's a screen grab of the Wall Street Journal's editorial. This surprised me. I don't want to lead you into your answer, but was this surprising to you?
Yeah, I saw that as well, and it was surprising to me, if for no other reason than what President Trump talked about. Now, keep in mind, when he spoke to these supporters before the assault on the Capitol by a select, maybe 1% of these otherwise peaceful protesters, he never obviously said to charge the Capitol. He was talking about illegality in the vote, but he wasn't talking about fraud. He was talking about the fact that election laws, state election laws that were duly enacted by those state legislatures, had been overridden by administrators, executives, and the courts, which makes them unconstitutional. He was professing his legal opinion, and a correct one, I would submit, that those elections under that regimen was unconstitutional. To say that kind of speech warrants a resignation, that kind of speech, which is constitutionally protected.
Yeah.
You know, and then in the late 1960s, the Supreme Court set out a test for what is inciting a riot. And this is clearly not that. Inciting a riot would be, you have to be speech that's directed to imminent lawless action and likely to produce it. This was anything but that. This is a person, a president, in a political context, talking about illegal grounds for challenging an election. And for the Wall Street Journal to turn around and say that this warrants a resignation, and for the leaders of the House and for the forthcoming majority leader of the Senate to suggest that he should either be impeached or removed under the 25th Amendment, that is the true assault on democracy, not the invasion of the Capitol.
Amir, at worst, I think President Trump was doing what you do at political rallies, what any politician does, and that's to engage and fire up the crowd. At worst, I guess there's gray area there. I will grant you that. We got about 10 seconds left, but the president has hinted at possibly pardoning himself over the next 12 days. Can he do that?
There's constitutional debate on that, but I think the weight of authority is that he cannot. And the reason why is that even though the text of the Constitution seems to give him total power to pardon whomever he pleases, the Constitution is premised on the notion that nobody is above the law. Right. And if the president is able to pardon himself for federal crimes, he would, in fact, be placing himself above the law. So I don't think that he would have the power to do that.
All right. That is Amir Benno. Thanks so much for your time. We appreciate it. Happy